Hello, dear student. I welcome on behalf of GP Kolhapur. Today we are going to start the session with this subject, that is manufacturing processes. So before starting this, you just know about manufacturing and you must know about the processes. Manufacturing means what? To prepare some required product that will fulfill our demand. So that is the manufacturing in the product and processes. So we need some media to convert raw materials into some desired, some required finished product. So that is called as the processes. So in manufacturing processes, if I can explain with the help of this diagram. So draw this diagram. This is the output. This is the input. And this is some media, some means required, that is processes. These are the various processes. Output is the finished product. And input is the raw materials. Various raw materials are taken at the input end. Those are processed, those are converted into the output, that is your finished product. So this is all about the manufacturing processes. This is the basic concept of manufacturing process. If we start with pattern making. So this is pattern making, molding, welding, casting, forming, punching, forging, all are the processes, mechanical processes. So those are used to convert raw materials into finished product. So let us start with pattern making. This pattern making is nothing but a manufacturing process. In this, we require some pattern. What is the meaning of pattern? Pattern is nothing but a photocopy. Or replica. Or it is prototype model. It is the prototype of model that we are going to be casted at the last. Means this is the model required to be casted. So if I want to manufacture, this image. This is the dumbbells. If I want to manufacture the dumbbells by pattern making, molding and casting. So to manufacture this dumbbell, we require pattern making process, then molding, and then we also require casting. So first prepare the model of this dumbbell, that is called as a pattern. Then go for the molding process, sand molding process, then go for the casting process. Pattern making means what? Prepare the replica of this dumbbell. How you are going to prepare the replica? You prepare this dumbbell into halves. So this is the half pattern. And prepared another pattern also. This is the second pattern. So two patterns are there. If I join together, so I required some modes in this. Half of in one piece, I required mode. And here I required tau in beads. These are the beads. When I assemble these two together, two pieces are joined together, then it looks like this is the parting line and how it gets joined together. This is the parting line. So this is called as a wooden pattern. Because it is made up of wood. This is called as wooden pattern. It is made up of wood. That's why it is called as a wooden pattern. If I assemble these two parts together, right, I will have this wooden pattern. So now, how you are going to cast number of pieces? Because it is made up of wooden, you are going to manufacture this by metal. This is manufactured from the cast iron, suppose. Cast iron is the final metal of this dumbbells. Cast iron is the material. So you can, from this one piece of wooden pattern, you can cast number of dumbbells. Means in large quantity you are going to cast it. So what is the process? Then how you are going to manufacture this dumbbell? Take the one match plate. This is the rectangular match plate. It looks like this, rectangular, match plate, having some this. So this is just like match plate. Place this match plate on the ground floor. Place half of the this pattern on the match plate. Again, place the that box, rectangular box on this. Now, through the opening, pour the sand around this pattern, pour the sand. And you place it, that is called as a ramming. This is box, this is match plate. And this is pattern. Half pattern, half wooden pattern, and this is sand, and by means of some mallet or some tools, you press, that is called as a ramming of sand. So once you ram it, all the sand particles stick together. Now, you take this match plate, so match plate becomes in this position, it looks like now on the top, this is the box. Now we remove this match plate. It can be easily removed. So remove this match plate. Now there is a pattern. So you shake this pattern and remove this pattern. So what you will get? You will have a mold cavity inside the sand. Inside this box, there is the mold cavity. Now similarly, again you put the match plate on the ground floor, put another half pattern on the match plate. Again, put the box, pour the sand. Pour the sand, it will take all the spaces around the pattern. Press that sand particles, that is called as ramming. Again, tilt it, remove this, so you will have another cavity here. So this looks like this. The top portion of the box is called as a coat box, and this is called as a grab box. And now here use One is rudder, plastic pipe, and another is riser. And this is occupied with the sand around the cavity. Now there is a handle for the box so that you can easily lift it. Now this is the mold we are having, the mold cavity. This portion is called as a runner. This is called as a riser. And now this is mold cavity. Mold cavity, which cavity is created. In Marathi, you are calling it as a sacha. Sacha is prepared by this process. This is called as a molding process. This is all about the molding process. Pattern making means what? Two pieces are prepared in manufacture by using wood. So that is called as a pattern making. Now, now take the crucible. Take crucible. Crucible is manufactured from ceramic material. So this is just like a cup. In this cup, take the pieces of cast iron. Take the pieces of cast iron inside this. So the volume of the cast iron is required, that depends on the calculation. How much is the volume of this? I'm not writing. How much is the volume of this cavity? So according to that, the weight of the cast iron is to be decided, and these cast iron pieces are heated by burner, and the pieces are converted into liquid form. So you are calling it as a molten metal. This is molten metal. Once it reaches one thermocouple is there. That thermocouple will indicate the temperature. So when certain temperature will reach, means all the pieces are converted, all the solid pieces of cast iron are converted into molten form. And now take this crucible and pour the molten material from the runner. So it will come from this downside of the half pattern and then goes through the riser. It rises up to this. After filling this portion, so all the portions are filled up with the molten metal. After filling this, where it will go, it rises again. In this riser will indicate that all the portions of the cavity gets filled with the molten metal and it rises. So this riser will indicate that. So keep this. So this is called as a casting process. Casting means what? Take the material in a crucible, metal pieces in a crucible, heat that metal pieces up to certain temperature and convert that into molten form and take that crucible and pour it into the mold cavity and keep this mold cavity for a certain amount of period. And that process is called as solidification. Solidifying means solidification needs to be carried out. Once you keep the liquid or molten metal at room temperature, that means solidifying. Means that molten metal is converted into solid. Means this portion, this portion is converted into solid formation. So remove this coke and dry box and destroy the sand particles, destroy the sand by hammer. Easily the sands are destroyed and at the last you will have this particular solid part you are getting at the last. And this is the riser. Now cut this by cutter. Cut the runner and riser. At the last you will have a solid that is manufactured from cast iron. So this is the garbage manufactured from plastic. So some parting line will be there. You find this parting line. So finish it by some finishing processes. Some binding needs to be carried out, and we will have the garbage. So this is all about the pattern making, molding, and casting. Okay. Thank you.